Common enough scene, a busy high street in a typical town centre. One of its key features is the now familiar estate agent's office. With many more people than ever before buying houses, these offices are geared towards an inquiring public. Their business is to tell us what is for sale, but they rarely give advice on safe home ownership. And how many of us consider the very real danger of fire in our homes? The size of the house or status of the homeowner bear no relation to the hazards which may be present therein. Let's take as an example an average-sized terraced house. Structurally sound and from the outside apparently safe enough. But it is only when we look closely inside that we may see the dangers which so very often go unnoticed. As we take our first look around the house, try and picture how many hazards there are which may present a danger from fire. A number of potential dangers are obvious, but a great many more often go unseen until it is too late. Television and video recorder would normally give little cause for concern, but is there adequate ventilation around the TV set? And what about that adapter? If at all possible, these should be avoided. General rule is one plug per socket, and this must be heeded at all times. Another wise precaution is to disconnect all electrical equipment at night. Electric cable is another hazard. Check there are no breaks in the insulation exposing bare wires. If two cables are to be joined, use a proper coupling. Don't just bind the two together. And never run an electrical cable under a carpet. Cable which is allowed to lie beneath a carpet in this manner could cause serious damage, which would subsequently go unnoticed. The location and misuse of a waste paper bin can also be a source of danger from fire. Do not place a waste paper bin close to curtains or other flammable materials, and as the name implies, its function is to contain waste paper and not discarded cigarettes or matches. These must be properly extinguished and placed in a suitable container, such as an ashtray, but be careful not to overload the ashtray or place it in an unstable position. The sighting of mirrors in the house is equally as important, and these should never be hung over a fireplace, as it encourages people to come too near. The child's toy has also been carelessly left on the mantelpiece. Too easily, children are badly burned trying to reach for something above a fire, especially an unguarded fire. Having seen the dangers in just one room of the house, what about the rest of the family home? There are still many more dangers from fire and many more potentially fatal situations. Electric irons are not only dangerous to an inquisitive child who may be able to reach it, but can present a very great hazard if again carelessly located, as in this case where the ironing board is far too close to the fire, and consequently, the clothes are hanging dangerously close to the again unguarded fire. Worse still are the towels which have been allowed to dry on top of the fire. This must never happen for obvious reasons. Record players, particularly hi-fi systems, can also pose a hidden danger from fire. Each part of the system has its own plug, and so again the danger of overloading the supply by using adapters is evident. Once again, it must be stressed, one plug per socket at all times. From the dining room, we pass through to the kitchen, possibly the most dangerous area with regards to fire, and most certainly the one room where the majority of accidents in the home occur. But again, these can be prevented by prudent and careful action. The heart of any kitchen is the cooker, and it is this one appliance which gives rise to the greatest concern over fire safety, especially if gas is the source of heat. Thought must be given to the storage of matches. Never leave them where a child can reach. Panhandles too can be badly positioned, as in this case where again a child could reach up or the pan could be knocked off the cooker by accident. Ensure that flex from electrical appliances, such as a kettle, do not lie across the cooker hot plates. Tea towels, or washing, should not be left to dry over the cooker, again, for obvious reasons. And of course, the chip pan, potentially explosive if misused. Most kitchen fires are caused by cooking oil overheating. To minimise the chance of this happening, never leave a chip pan unguarded on the hot plate, and never more than half fill the pan with cooking oil. Kitchen fires can also be brought about by the careless storage of waste paper or other flammable material near heat. The same is true of aerosol containers, which must never be stored in direct sunlight or close to sources of heat, such as this central heating boiler. Outside, it is important to ensure that vents are never blocked, whilst for safety reasons, the pilot light must never be extinguished. And so, onto the hall and stairs. Here again, there are hazards which might otherwise go unnoticed. The heater itself causes no real concern when treated properly and with respect. But look at how it has been positioned. That door may be your only escape in fire, and it must always be kept clear of obstructions. As well as the hall, the stairs too must be kept clear and allow free access for your escape. As we climb the stairs, our first call is the bathroom. Electrical equipment must never be used in here. Electricity and ducts may have an affinity for water, but ducts fare rather better than radios when exposed to it. Water is a very good conductor of electricity, and therefore lethal. The children's room can also hide a number of dangers. Toys are an integral part of this room, but keep them well away from any room heaters. Do not have lengths of cable snaking across the floor, as this may cause an accident and impede escape in case of fire. And where possible, blank off any unused sockets to prevent electrical shock from inquisitive fingers. And we finish with the main bedroom. Once again, it is surprising to note just how many common hazards do go unnoticed. Cigarettes are again a very great hazard in the bedroom. It is strongly advised that you never smoke in bed. If an electric blanket is to be used, always ensure that it is kept flat and dry. And follow the manufacturer's instructions very carefully. And always ensure that the blanket conforms to British Standard 3456. Always buy nightwear made from flame retardant materials, such as 100% nylon or 100% polyester. And finally, never, ever cover a lamp. If it is too bright, put in a lower wattage bulb. There are a number of leaflets available from the Fire Safety Unit which more thoroughly explain about home fire safety. To ignore their advice would be chancing more than just your arm. Remember, prevention is always the better cure.